You know, cutting and trimming flagstone is not as difficult as you might think. Matter of fact, I kind of enjoy doing it. Maybe I shouldn't admit that. But anyway, I'm going to show you a few little tricks that will help you cut flagstone just like the pros. And you'll be eager to get out and go beat on some rocks yourself. Now on small projects, a little pathway maybe, if you only have 10, 15, 20 stones, no need to run out and spend $40 or $50 on a fancy rock hammer. Your good old-fashioned claw hammer will do just fine. Now if the flagstone you're using is pretty thin, say 1.5 inches or less, then it chips away pretty easily. There's really three different types of cuts you need to know, and then you can cut any flagstone. The first type of cut is for the bigger stones, and it's what we call a snap or a break. Now, let me just say right now, we never just go wailing hard on a rock. We always want to control where it breaks and cut the rock to fit. To break a big rock accurately, we will do what is called checking. Prop the rock up so it's hollow underneath. Make a little scratch mark where you want it to break, and start applying a series of light taps with your claw hammer. Now the trick here is to use the very edge of the hammer, not the flat head, but just the very edge right there. And what that does is condenses the force of the blow into a very small footprint that eventually forms a series of microscopic fractures that grow into one big fault line that is where that rock is going to cut. When you start, stay in from the edge 3 or 4 inches or so we don't blow out a chunk of the edge. And start by applying a series of light taps about 3 or 4 inches apart. Each pass, make them slightly closer together. Start to listen to the rock and it'll start to tell you when it's getting weaker and weaker. Continue checking the rock and eventually it'll snap right where we want it to. This works good on rocks up to about 3 or 4 inches in thickness. Any thicker than that, and it requires such a tremendous force that the accuracy is greatly reduced. The second cutting technique is when we need to remove a fair amount of material close to the edge of the stone. First, we need to lay the rock down good and flat, and then start by coming in about 1/2 inch, and always use the edge of the hammer, just like we did on the snapping and the checking. And start by removing 1/2 inch at a time. Work your way closer to the mark. The undercut here actually aids us in chipping away towards the mark, but in areas where it's bellied out, try to come in from the edge and make an undercut in that area. Now it's easier to chip away towards the mark. Come to within 1/4 inch or so of the mark. The final step is referred to as edging. Once we've worked our way down to the mark, it's often ragged. Using the flat edge of the hammer, beat away at those peaks and ridges to knock them down flat. Make this edge just as straight and as perfect as you want. Now on this stepstone pathway, let me just lay these rocks out untrimmed. They look okay, but it could be better. Let's try this. Let's knock off some corners to take away some of that rectangular shape. It looks a little better now, doesn't it? Now since we're rock pros, let's really change it up. Using what we've learned, we can trim these rocks into a pleasing round shape. Etch a corner and start chipping away, and go all the way around the rock so there are no straight lines. Continue until the pathway is complete, and look at what a dramatic difference that made. Now we buried these step stones in a little bit so they're flush with the ground, swept a little mulch in the cracks, but you can see what a big difference it made by rounding these stones up compared to their original rectangular and jagged edged look. Now most stones on a pallet, if you purchase a whole pallet of stones, are processed for the masonry trade, and there's going to be some very irregular stones in there. And masons know how to cut those and utilize those and use every stone in the pallet, and now you can too.